convention center on beautiful Mississippi Beach. The 1993 Miss Teen USA pageant. Starring 51 of the most outstanding teenagers in the USA. With your host, Dick Clark. Co-host, Arvell Neville. Special commentator, Miss Teen USA 1985, Kelly Wu. The reigning Miss Teen USA, Iowa's Jamie Solander. And the Mississippi Gulf Coast Teen Orchestra and Chorus. And now, here are the 51 contestants for the title of Miss Teen USA 1993.
Looking good. Thank you ever so much. That was perfect. We're off to a great start. You look wonderful. And it's nice to be back. Happy that you're all here with us to help celebrate living in the 90s. And the Miss Teen USA pageant is very happy to be here on the Gulf Coast in beautiful Mississippi Beach for the fourth year. And thank you again ever so much for your wonderful Southern hospitality. Isn't it great? You make us feel right at home. The new Miss Teen USA is somewhere in this terrific group, and actually you only got a couple of hours to find her, and I wouldn't set out on a mission like this alone, so please welcome my co-host, former news anchor who now interviews the stars as host of Extreme Close-Up for E! Entertainment Television, Miss Arthel Neville.
Woo! Hi, ladies! Hi, ladies!
Oh, you are looking good, too. We got a good group now.
Oh.
This is your neighborhood, isn't it?
Surely is. Born and raised in New Orleans. Secret. Too much catfish.
No. You know, if anybody is listening to that name, Neville, that's a well-known name. Drop a few relatives.
I don't know him. No. Art Neville is my father. Aaron, Charles, and Cyril are my uncles. And Doris Neville is my mother.
This is a very musical family. How come you didn't ended up? No, what a command of English he has. How come we aren't a singer?
Well, you know, I wanted to use the voice for speaking.
There you go. You do a beautiful job. Well, we got to get down to brass tacks now and tell this audience how this competition tonight is working. During the past week, our contestants completed a round of preliminary competition.
That's right. And during the preliminaries, the judges scored the girls in three events, which weigh equally in selecting the 12 semifinalists.
The swimsuit competition in which they modeled identical suits.
The evening gown competitions with the contestants wearing gowns which they chose themselves.
And the interview competition where each judge talked individually with each contestant.
Now the scores from these three events have been added an average for the contestants' preliminary ranking.
And you will see the three scores each young lady received in just a moment as we begin our traditional parade of states.
That's right, and I'm going to report to you the rest of the scores throughout the evening.
Up yonder.
He gave me the nosebleed section.
Not by yourself. That's a good seat. You see everything up there.
You're right. I'm not going to be alone. Elvis is up there.
No, come on. Come on. Don't start with me on that stuff. Who is there with you?
Our special commentator is Kelly Hu. She won the Miss Teen USA title in 1985.
And I got 51 ladies back here who'd like to take that crown home with them tonight. Let's go to work.
Let's do it. You're on your own now.
I'm all by myself.
See you later.
Yonder, ladies and gentlemen, Arthel Neville. All right, now as our contestants introduce themselves, you'll see each young lady's preliminary score and a visual reminder of how she looked in the preliminaries. Ladies and gentlemen, Here are the 51 contestants for the title of Miss Teen USA 1993.
Living in the 90s.
We begin with the contestants from the South, Miss Maryland.
I represent Maryland, home of the U.S. Naval Academy. From Linthicum, I'm Angelisa Proserpi.
Miss Tennessee.
From Nashville, Tennessee, where country is always king, I am Jamie Dudney.
Miss Arkansas.
Arkansas, the natural land of opportunity. From Jacksonville, I'm Tiffany Park.
Miss Oklahoma.
A boomer singer through and through. From Tell, Oklahoma, I'm Stacy Caroline Kane.
Miss Kentucky.
Lucas Miles, Kentucky, home from the bluegrass state of fast horses, I am Holly Riggs.
Miss North Carolina.
A Tar Heel born and a Tar Heel bred. From Four Points, North Carolina, I am Wendy Marie Williams.
Miss West Virginia.
From beautiful Morgantown, West Virginia,
Miss Louisiana.
From Baton Rouge, Louisiana, where good things are always cooking, I am Heather Dupree.
Miss Alabama.
From the state of the 1992 football national champions, from Chelsea, Alabama, I'm Autumn Smith.
Miss South Carolina.
I hail from the Palmetto State, from Lexington, South Carolina. My name is Lauren Popel.
Miss Florida.
Proud to represent the Sunshine State of Florida, from
Miss Virginia.
I represent Virginia, birthplace of eight presidents. From historical Fredericksburg, I am Heather Anderson.
Miss Georgia.
I represent Georgia, future host of the world for the 96 Olympics. From Fayetteville, I am Vanessa Reed.
Miss Mississippi.
Welcome to the great hospitality state of Mississippi. From Mars, I am Bridget King.
Look into the future.
And now the contestants from the Northeast, Miss Pennsylvania.
From Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, the state of brotherly love, I am Ursula Abbott.
Miss New York.
Representing the beautiful Empire State of New York, from Queensbury, my name is Sarah Ray Gore.
Miss Delaware.
The first state of liberty and freedom is my home. From Newark, Delaware, I am Catherine Wong.
Miss Vermont.
I hail from the Green Mountain State. From Georgia, Vermont, I'm Charlotte Lopez.
Miss Massachusetts.
From Natick, Massachusetts, where the spirit of the American Revolution lives on, my name is January Newcomb.
Miss New Jersey.
I'm representing the Great Garden State of New Jersey. From Galloway Township, my name is Heather Brenner.
Miss New Hampshire.
From Lancaster, in the beautiful White Mountain State of New Hampshire, I am Gretchen Lynn Durgan.
Miss District of Columbia.
Representing our nation's capital, from the District of Columbia, my name is Rebecca Slobing.
Miss Rhode Island.
I'm representing the proud ocean state of Rhode Island. From North Kingstown, I'm Elisa Currier.
Miss Connecticut.
From Wilson in the Constitution State of Connecticut, my name is Cynthia Schneck.
Miss Maine.
I hail from the vacation jewel of New England. From Hollis, Maine, my name is Jill Aaron Mellon.
Learning what we stand for.
Now the contestants from the Southwest, Miss Texas.
The great Lone Star State is my home. From Plano, Texas, my name is Erin Burnett.
Miss Nevada.
From America's fastest growing community, Las Vegas, Nevada, I am Tammy Rankin.
Miss California.
I hail from California, the Golden State. From El Dorado Hills, my name is Stephanie Sweeney.
Miss Colorado.
From third in the beautiful Rocky Mountain High State of Colorado, my name is Cindy Griffin.
Miss Utah.
From Sandy, Utah, the state with the greatest snow on earth, I am Amy Elizabeth Carlson.
Miss Arizona.
Grand Canyon, state of Arizona, is my home. From Phoenix, I'm Danielle Normandin.
Miss Hawaii.
Aloha from Honolulu, Hawaii. I'm Juliana Kaulukupui.
Miss New Mexico.
The land of enchantment is my desert home. From Deming, New Mexico, I am Lynette Ochoa.
Proud to be a woman.
The contestants from the Northwest, Miss Alaska.
North to the future is our motto. From Anchorage, Alaska, I'm Christy Michelle Thorson.
Miss Montana.
Big Sky Country is my home. From Telescope, Montana, my name's Angela Hope Carter.
Miss Washington.
Hello, from Vancouver, Washington, the state that's got it all, I am Rebecca K. Vaughn.
Miss Wyoming.
Greetings from a great land outdoors. From Gillette, Wyoming, my name is Lana Renee Hansen.
Miss Idaho.
The gem state where I call home. From Barnes Ferry, Idaho, I am Jan Cartwright.
Miss is Oregon.
Roseburg, Oregon, in the heart of the great American Northwest Forest, I'm Jewel Cartier.
The contestants from the Midwest, Miss Missouri.
From Mountain Grove in the great Show Me State of Missouri, I am Melanie Janine Breedlove.
Miss Kansas.
From Augusta, Kansas, where the folks still believe there's no place like home, I am Christy Dupree.
Miss Wisconsin.
The great dairy state of Wisconsin is my home. From Hudson, I am Tanae Gabrielle Geisler.
Miss Ohio.
I hail from the great Buckeye state of Ohio. From Cincinnati, my name is Melissa Yost.
Miss Minnesota.
From Stacy, Minnesota, the land of 10,000 spectacular lakes, I am Charity Rose Lundy.
Miss Indiana.
The thrilling Indy 500 is where I call home.
From Indianapolis, Indiana, my name is Kelly Lloyd.
Miss Nebraska.
The great Cornhusker state of Nebraska is my home. From Omaha, I am Laureate Logan.
Miss Michigan.
Good evening. From the Great Lakes state of Michigan, my name is Ashley Renee Witt.
Miss Illinois.
I hail from Illinois, home of the three-time championship Chicago Bulls. From Cavern Rock, I'm Jamie Holbrook.
Miss Iowa.
From Marion, Iowa, in the heart of America's heartland, I am Melissa Baxter.
Miss South Dakota.
I represent South Dakota, home of Mount Rushmore. From Clear Lake, I am Amy Rao.
And Miss North Dakota.
Inviting you to discover the spirit of North Dakota. From Grand Forks, I'm Wendy Howe.
Just a moment, we will reveal our 12 semifinalists.
Beautiful Liz. Remarkable.
Introducing Remarkable.
Washable.
Waterproof mascara.
Covergirl.
The full definition brush singles out every lash.
Dramatically.
Day, beautiful lashes, you just
wash away.
Remarkable.
Beautiful is.
New Remarkable Mascara defines lashes all day, then you just wash it away.
Cover Girl.
Redefining beautiful.
See this? This is no room for error. Around this face is the place for a beautiful Ogilvy Precisely Right Perm. Precisely Right automatically times your perm, automatically conditions your hair, and when it's through, it shuts itself off. Which is why no other kind of perm gives you more beautiful, silky, shiny, glorious waves and curls every time. See this? This is no room for error. This is Precisely Right by Ogilvy. You just can't get it wrong.
Now, they may try to improve a pad by making it thinner.
Are you kidding?
They may put wings on it.
It won't fly.
They may even make it smaller.
Not small enough.
A Tampax tampon is smaller, so it fits naturally inside to protect you sooner.
Naturally.
So while they may keep changing it,
it's still a pad.
And not as comfortable to wear as a Tampax tampon. For great comfort and a dollar savings on Tampax tampons, look in Sunday's paper.
To our live show and our hangout up here in the sky, the anchor booth. Now, my partner up here tonight really knows the scenes behind the scenes in this pageant. She won it in 1985 and is here for the third time as special commentator. She is also the reigning Miss Hawaii USA. Meet Miss Kelly Hu. Hi, Kelly.
Hi, how are you?
Well, I know I'm excited because the girls are.
Yes.
This pageant for you launched your acting career, but you're doing TV, movies.
Yes, in fact, I have a movie coming out on August 20th. It's called Surf Ninjas, and it's with Ernie Reyes Jr., who happens to be one of our judges tonight.
Did you give him any judging tips?
I don't think he needed any. I think he's doing quite well.
Okay, now what? You've spent a couple of weeks with the group, and want to know, what's your impression of the girls?
You know, this is a very bright group. Their average GPA is a 3.5, and more than half of them are honors students. And Miss Delaware even has a perfect 1600 on her SAT.
Oh, my goodness. So we're talking brain power and beauty.
Right.
So who are the standouts?
You know, I really liked Miss California. I thought she was adorable on stage, but Miss Pennsylvania really blew us away. And Miss Hawaii is absolutely gorgeous, and of course she's from my home state.
Absolutely.
And I really am rooting for Miss Vermont. This girl is absolutely amazing, and she's got a great story to tell. I hope she makes it up there.
I know. By the way, the girls can't hear us dishing them up here, because, you know, we don't want to make anyone nervous.
And the judges can't hear us either, so we won't influence any scoring.
All right, now speaking of scoring, let's check out the top scores in the preliminary competitions, which took place this past week. Then, I want to remind you, there are no 10s here. Well, except me. No, just kidding. All right, the highest score a contestant can get is a 9.999. Oh, boy. Okay, topping the swimsuit competition, Miss Pennsylvania, followed by Miss Vermont there. Okay, Miss Vermont is tops in the interview competition with a 9.38. And notice Miss Pennsylvania, once again, she is here topping the evening gowns competition. Oh, check this out, Miss Ohio in all three categories. Gotta watch out for her. Okay, now that is just a hint. It may not necessarily tell us who the winner will be, though.
Right, because sometimes a girl will barely squeak into the semifinals, and then she'll come out strong and win it. In fact, I was only in fourth place at this point in the pageant.
Oh, I see. Strategy. You pretend you're going to lose, and then, bam, you come up and you win it, huh?
Strategy. I think luck was more like it, thanks.
Okay, let's see who the 12 semifinalists are tonight and see if you can predict which one of them will be the new Miss Teen USA.
This is the moment when we reveal the 12 semifinalists whom the judges have chosen to continue in tonight's competition. Let me pick up the results. I thank you, sir, very much. Now, as each semifinalist comes forward, you'll see her composite score on the screen. And ladies, if you're ready, I will read these names in random order. The semifinalists are Miss New York, Sarah Ray Gore.
She's the one who used to play pageant as a little girl.
That's right. Sarah told me she always won the pajama and stuffed animal competition.
Miss Georgia, Danessa Reed.
Would you believe Danessa has been in 5 pageants in the past year?
And maintained a perfect 4.0 grade average?
Unbelievable.
Miss South Carolina, Lauren Papel.
Lauren is so much fun. She's got a great smile.
And guess what? Her mother was voted Miss Flame when she was a girl.
Miss Indiana, Kelly Lloyd.
The other night at preliminaries, Kelly won the Most Beautiful Eyes Award.
And on top of that, she's been in 50 pageants. She is ready.
Miss Ohio, Melissa Yust.
Okay, Melissa was the one to place in top 5 in all 3 preliminary events.
Yeah, she's definitely one of the frontrunners.
Miss Oregon, Jill Chartier.
In the past 2 weeks down here, Jill has been the pageant clown.
That's right. She's always kidding around, so we can expect some laughs from her tonight.
All right, we're at the halfway mark. Next is Miss Tennessee, Jamie Dudney.
And, of course, Jamie is country singer Barbara Mandrell's daughter.
That's right, but she grew up around show business.
That's right, and she's very comfortable
Miss
on
Connecticut,
stage.
Cynthia Schneck.
Now, Connecticut has never made the semifinals before, but Cynthia did well in the interview, so she could finish pretty strong.
And she's been in 10 pageants, so
Miss
that should
Hawaii,
give her confidence.
Hawaii, Juliana Kolakakui.
Juliana won the Miss Congeniality Award.
Yeah, she just might follow in your footsteps, Miss Kelly.
There are 3 to go. Miss Vermont, Charlotte Lopez.
Oh, Kelly, your favorite made it.
And look at the numbers. Charlotte has the highest preliminary score so far.
Miss Maine, Jill Erin Mellon.
Now, Jill's modeling school encouraged her to enter this pageant.
And, Arthel, this is the first time Maine has made it to the semifinals.
There's one more. Miss Pennsylvania, Ursula Abbott.
Look at that score. She has tied Miss Vermont for the first place in the preliminary.
I think we have a real competition on our hands.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 12 semifinalists for the title of Miss Teen USA 1993.
They look excited, happy, scared, everything, all at the same time.
Well, they are because they're about to compete in swimsuit, evening gown, and interview all over again, and this time only in the top 12, so it's going to be a lot tougher now.
Oh boy, right, and all of those scores you saw from the preliminaries are erased, and the semifinalists begin again all even. And now the swimsuit competition is up first, and you know, I saw the girls in the preliminary Saturday night, and not to mention that I realized I need to go to the gym. They are all in great shape.
They are. These are girls who are really into fitness. Their average workout is about 11 and a half hours. hours a week.
You know, but it's representative of teens across the country because they love to work out. They're really health conscious these days. But I have to ask you, who is the fittest of the fit?
You know, Miss Indiana Kelly Lloyd, she is a track star and a medalist in the 100-meter hurdle. And Miss Tennessee Jamie Dudney, she plays polo. And get this, she has the same coach as Prince Charles.
But of course. And she works out with a football team on top of that.
Right.
And, you know, we know that Miss Pennsylvania, Ursula, who won the preliminary swimsuit competition, fabulous.
Oh, she looks great. And she told me that in her state pageant, it was huge. There were 167 contestants. And watch out for Miss New York. She is a cutie. She is a 5'3" girl, but she is absolutely adorable. And she stays in shape by being on a strict diet. Her sister sent her a fat-free care package while she was up here.
Fat-free, honey, I'm going to get her some pralines. Look, don't go away. You will see all of these fine young ladies in the Catalina swimsuit competition.
Are you taking chances with your feminine protection? Introducing a foolproof system from Stay Free called Personalized Protection. It's easy. You choose the level of protection you need in the style you prefer. Stay Free Classic or Ultra Thin. It's so simple because luck shouldn't have anything to do with getting the right protection. Personalized Protection from Stay Free. Better protection by choice, not chance.
Did you ever have a guy point one out to you?
Yeah, I mean, as if I don't know it's there.
Johnson's Clean and Clear, a foaming facial cleanser.
It's just a tiny little
temporary imperfection.
Nothing.
Deep cleaning, but now with a pharmaceutical ingredient no leading cleanser has.
Why couldn't it be right back here?
I'll just walk around like this.
Right here?
It kills problem-causing bacteria.
It builds character.
I have enough character.
Skin is clean, beautifully clear, and under control.
It's just a zit.
We said the Z word.
Clean and clear and under control.
You come into my place, I want you to feel like you come into my home. But I think the whole appearance of the restaurant should be really, really top quality. Everything has to be white, 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 white. You're always spilling something. At the end of the night, sometimes it looks like you've been in a food fight. It seemed no matter what I tried, no detergent really got it clean.
The power of Tide with Bleach. This regular detergent only gets it this white, but Tide with Bleach gets it whiter.
After all, in this business, presentation is everything.
If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide.
Absolute cleanliness. You can't get away with anything less.
Something's happening on CBS. It's about my family. They're the best. Tall Hopes is the name. It'll give you a lift when we premiere on August 25th.
Tide Picks, the best in entertainment. A chance to win prizes and a special look at David Letterman on CBS. Hot Picks, a free rental at Blockbuster Video.
An important message from America's Most Watched Network.
I have a special message for all you Debbies out there. Hey, Debbies!
Same day, better time, new station.
Welcome back to our live show from Mississippi Beach, and it's time now to meet our distinguished panel of judges. And as I introduce them, audience, if you would please hold your applause until the end. Delighting television audiences with her work on such series as Knots Landing, L.A. Law, and All My Children, she's Emmy Award-winning actress Kathleen Noon. A native of Mississippi, he now handles some of the entertainment world's biggest stars. He's Hollywood producer and star maker Larry Thompson. MTV personality and host of the new series Alternative Nation, she's one of television's most outspoken new talents. She's Kennedy. Star of the soon-to-be-released film Surf Ninjas, on which he was associate producer. He is actor, producer, and martial artist, Ernie Reyes, Jr. She spent the last 8 years seeking out the cover girls of tomorrow, director of model development for the Ford agency. She's Ann Gorison. Eighth round draft pick of the New York Rangers in 1991, he went undefeated in his first 15 professional starts. He's hockey goaltender Corey Hirsch. Former star of General Hospital, she's currently featured with Shannon Doherty and Judd Nelson in the feature film Blindfold. She's Shel Danielson. Supervising the casting of such popular hits as Beverly Hills 90210 and Melrose Place, he is Fox Network Vice President for Talent, Bob Harbin. As Vice President of Program Development, her credits include Star Search, Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, and her upcoming series, Home Videos of the Stars. She is Noreen Donovan. He got his start on daytime drama, just got back from starring with Dolph Lundgren in the upcoming feature, Pentathlon. Please welcome Biloxi's own Gerald Hopkins. Ladies and gentlemen, our judges.
Scoring system similar to the Olympics. As each contestant competes, each judge enters a score ranging from 1.0
to a high of 9.99 into the computer terminal. You'll see the judges' names and scores on your screen. Then the highest and lowest scores are eliminated, and the rest are averaged like this. Finally, each contestant's average scores in the swimsuit interview and evening gown competitions are added, and the top six composite scores will determine the six finalists. Well, it looks like the competition's about to begin, so why don't you at home keep your own scores and see how your choices compare with our judges.
Thanks, Kelly. You know, beautiful Mississippi Beach and the Gulf of Mexico are just a few steps from the front doors of this theater, so we decided to bring some of that summer door and fun indoors from the outdoors, and our contestants are ready to set the mood for the swimsuit competition. Full of vim and vigor. Now we're ready to begin the Catalina swimsuit competition with our 12 semifinalists. The ladies will also be wearing Federico Leone espadrilles as they compete. We've asked them to tell us a little bit more about themselves, and we begin with Miss New York.
Okay, when I was a little girl, I was really shy. And then I went to this crazy stage at home. My sisters used to make me do all these crazy things. They used to make me jump off roofs. They used to put me on their feet and launch me into the walls. And amazingly, I'm still alive today.
Miss Georgia.
I found a quite unique way of staying in shape. I work as a volunteer at the Dog River Animal Sanctuary. And my job is to chase the animals around after they get out of their cages. So when I get home, I'm exhausted. I'm ready to kick my feet up and relax.
Miss South Carolina.
If I've learned anything in life, it would be to be yourself, work hard, and never let your fears destroy your hopes.
Miss Indiana.
I've always been very good at science. And I have a great love for children. So I decided I would combine science and my love for children together and develop a career in pediatrics. It's a lot of schooling, but I'm really determined.
Miss Ohio.
My house is known as the Animal House. We have a dog, a rabbit, and a skunk, and also ducks. Every year we would get a few ducks, and they'd fly away to go down south, and when they would come back, they would bring their family and friends. So now we have 42 ducks living in our back pond.
Miss Oregon.
Okay, when I was a little girl, I used to write different songs and perform different skits and just entertain my family at different reunions and functions. And I've always had the nature that I love to entertain people, and I feel like if I can make someone smile, then I'm doing a great job, and that really makes me happy.
Miss Tennessee.
I grew up loving animals, and just like my babies. And I have four cats, a dog, an iguana, two doves, a horse, tropical fish, and a tack bird. And every time somebody comes into my house, he screams at the top of his lungs, and it scares the people half to death. So that's why we call him our tack bird.
Miss Connecticut.
I most admire Arnold Schwarzenegger, not because he's a star, but for what he's done on the President's Council for Physical Fitness. He's gone around the world teaching children the importance of having a drug-free, alcohol-free, healthy body and mind, and that's the way I try to lead my life.
Miss Hawaii.
This fall, I'll be going to college in California. It'll be my first time away from home and first time living on the mainland, but at the same time, Hawaii will always be my home. It's a very special place to me. It's where I grew up, and I'll always love it.
Miss Vermont.
I have a blast when I work out. Whether I'm working hard in the gym or biking or rollerblading outside, I'm always doing it with a bunch of my friends. It's always fun, and afterwards we always reward ourselves with an ice cream from Tasty Breeze.
Miss Maine.
I'm more of a
type of person that likes to enjoy the time on my own and be real relaxed, opposed to living in a city where it's very congested and noisy. I say I'd rather live not on a deserted island, but maybe someplace far off so I can enjoy the time by myself and be real laid back.
Miss Pennsylvania.
I've kept a diary since seventh grade, and I usually fill it with poems and things like that. And back then I'd write about flowers and butterflies and rainbows and silly things that didn't mean anything to anybody, but they were important to me, and I'd just die if anyone ever saw those things.
That was sensational, ladies. That completes the swimsuit competition for Miss Teen USA 1993.
It's official. Gotta go to the gym. All right, let's see how the judges scored this competition. Oh, look at this. Miss Pennsylvania tops this 12th semifinalist competition. Remember, she won in the preliminaries, followed by Miss Indiana. And Vermont tops there, too. Now, there she is again, Miss Ohio, down there. Looking good, looking really good. Miss Tennessee, a little surprised there, but there's more time for her to come back. And by the way, Catalina will award the winner, Miss Pennsylvania, either a cash prize of $1,000 or a photo modeling contract worth $2,500. All right, now while the contestants are backstage changing, why don't we check in with the ranging Miss Teen USA, Miss Jamie Solinger, and see what they've been up to in this Mississippi Beach area. Jamie?
They've been having such a great time, Arthel, and we've got it all on tape right here in our edit bay. Come and join in on the fun. Roll tape, Woody. Why am I wrong screen, Woody?
Okay, this is a lot better. Let's go meet the girls that are just arriving.
Hi, how's your flight?
Good.
Good, great. How's your flight?
Great.
You know, there's a little mass confusion here. Are you ready to jump in? Let's go and start the show.
Oh, great. It's pretty busy already, huh? So what
do you think? Oh, I love it.
I love it?
Every minute of it.
A lot of fun. Happy holiday. Have fun dancing. Hey, let's go on to registration.
First day of registration is the most hectic day ever. Let's go see what's going on with the photographer. Hi, Don.
Hi, how
busy
are you?
Day, huh?
Yep. 51 prettiest girls in the USA are right here.
Isn't that true?
Hey.
Hi, guys. How about those titties? How do you think?
Oh, I enjoy these much more than I enjoy high heels.
So, what size do you wear?
8.5.
8.5? All right, so let's see. What do you think of the suits? Pretty tough choices?
Yeah.
A lot of cute suits, huh?
They're really cute this year. And the best part is we're all having the same competition thing.
How about if we go on over here and see what's going on? Hi, guys. Look at the Catalina sportswear. The sportswear looks great. So what do you think?
I think it's wonderful.
Yeah. Hey, Utah. Hey. Utah's back. Let's look in here and see what's going on. What's all in here? Hawaiian Tropic.
Wow. Makeup.
Cover Girls. Caboodle.
Camera.
Aaron, looks like you're all set with a bag of goodies. Here we are in Mississippi Beach, and look at the girls having lots of fun. What are you guys building?
Sand castle!
All right. Oh, look, there's some of the girls out there playing. I'm going to go give them a surprise.
Now, I don't know.
Like you're here for a while.
Sure am.
I think everyone's already took off for fun time.
Are you going to help me out?
No, nope, rest in peace, Kansas. Ah! Later. Amazing. You know, these bayou evenings are just wonderful. Let's go over and see what the girls are doing. Hi, guys.
Hi. Hi.
See them go by? That's pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Well, how's the fishing going?
Great.
Any dinner yet?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Soon, though.
What's the recipe?
Cinnamon sugar roll.
Mustard.
Looks like this is
the perfect ending for all the fun they've had. Have you guys had fun?
Yeah!
All right, thanks a lot, Jamie. I called her the ranging Miss Teen USA. You know what I mean, the raining Miss Teen. It's too much rain down here anyway. All right, the interview competition is up next, and I have to find out what is the judges looking for in this, and who has it?
Well, you know, the judges want the girls to be articulate but spontaneous. They don't want any of that pageant patter.
I know, it gets so robotic up there, you know?
Exactly, exactly. And you know, Miss Hawaii, Juliana Ka'ulukukui, who has $25,000 worth of scholarship, she can really think on her feet. And Miss Georgia, Denisha Reed, she has a perfect 4.0 GPA.
Woof, that's pretty good. And Miss Vermont, you know, she won the preliminary interview competition. She's so much fun.
She is a wonderful girl. And Charlotte told me she's writing a book about her life in foster care.
Ooh, good. I can't wait to hear that. I'm so glad you had to say Miss Hawaii's name. You will get to know all 12 semifinalists better in just a moment, so stay tuned for the interviews.
Picture this. Our biggest portrait offer ever is at Sears Portrait Studios right now. Yeah, $12.95 gets you more than twice as many big portraits. 3 10x13s, 4 8x10s, 6 5x7s, and a lot more. Right now at Sears.
It's pre-filled for convenience.
Precisely.
We measure for just the right amount.
Precisely.
New Gynalotrimin pre-filled. 7 applicators make curing a yeast infection easier.
Precisely.
Only from Gynalotrimin, the right cure, such a relief.
Obviously, giving up showers is not an option. But I'll do whatever it takes to keep my skin's moisture from going down the drain. New Oil of Olay Bath Bar is very different. Of course it's got light Olay moisture like young skin. But get this. Unlike soap, it actually helps hold moisture in. So my skin feels soft, smooth, wonderfully young. Suddenly, showers have a whole new meaning.
Hold on to young skin with New Oil of Olay Bath Bar. And the price? Very nice.
The 1993 Miss Teen USA pageant will continue.
So you want to move your family back home to be closer to your parents.
Which do you think is worse? My mother, who thinks I can do no right.
Oh, I'm glad you asked me over so I could sit alone in your living room.
Or your mother, who thinks you can do no wrong.
Give me those kids.
Mine.
Peter Scolari and Pamela Reed. Family album coming soon to CBS. Get the answers to your most amazing questions. 4 people found the courage to walk into the eye of a riot to save Reginald Denny. How'd they do that? Find out Wednesday.
Is your blood pressure so high you need medication, or will just diet and exercise be enough? We'll clear up the confusion. Then it's off to Beverly Hills for bargain shopping at the poshest of pawn shops. And find out if The Fugitive is a movie you'll want to catch. Tomorrow on CBS This Morning with Harry Smith and Paula Zahn. Breakfast for your head.
This is CBS.
Great tasting Diet Right Cola is sodium free. And since it doesn't have any calories, it won't show up here. Or here. Or here. Oh, and also, it doesn't have any caffeine. This is who your mother wants you to be. This is who your father wants you to be. This is who your boyfriend wants you to be. This is who your other boyfriend wants you to be. This is who your left brain wants you to be. This is who your right brain wants you to be. This is who your ex-best friend wants you to be. This is what your brother wants you to be. The hard part is figuring out who you want to be. Oh, and also which genes fit you best.
You're watching KMTV, Channel 3, your top story station.
Welcome back to Mississippi Beach as we continue our live competition with the interviews. Now, the new Miss Teen USA is not only a role model for teenagers, but during her reign, she's also going to meet a lot of people, talk with a wide variety of folks in her travels, and for that reason, the judges know that her communication skills are very important. Now, these interviews are spontaneous, they're unrehearsed, and the contestants are judged on poise, intelligence, personality, and, of course, the content of their answers. And we'll begin with Miss New York. This is Sarah Ray Gore. She's 17 years old. She's an A student who enjoys modeling, volleyball, doing volunteer work for the homeless. Now, your last name is Gore. Are you any relation to the vice president?
No, I'm not. I wrote him a letter, though, and he didn't write me back yet.
Well, he's a very busy guy. What'd you say to him?
About the homeless. They're closing down a lot of military bases, and I think they should put the homeless in there for shelter or education. And I'm going to write again, though, hoping he's going to send me back a letter, maybe invite me to the White House.
I guarantee after this, his constituents are going to say, answer that woman from New York.
I thought he'd answer me because we have the same last name.
Well, you got to realize he gets a lot of mail. Now, let me turn the subject over a little bit. You're 17 years of age. You've got your whole life in front of you. What are your plans?
Well, I plan to take over my father's business and become a CPA.
Wait a minute. Does he know anything about this yet?
He does. He's over there. Yes, he does. Me and my sister actually have plans to take it over if my acting career doesn't work out.
All right. Now, wait a minute. You're going to back up and be an accountant if you're not an actress. All right. Whatever. Whatever makes you happy. Are you good with money?
Yes, very good. I have more money than my sister's put together in the bank, actually.
I mean, this is your own money you're very careful with?
Yes, it's all my own money.
All right, congratulations. Good luck. If you will, please step over here for the judges. This is Miss New York. All right, next is Miss Georgia. This is Dinesha Reed. She's 18 years old, a college freshman with straight A's. Enjoys volunteering her time at local animal shelters. What do you do at the shelter? What kind of jobs do you get?
Well, I work as a volunteer at the Dog River Animal Sanctuary, and it's located in Atlanta. And one of my jobs is to choose animals for the petting zoo compound, so I chase animals around. And I also exercise cougars and servals.
You exercise?
I exercise them. I run them around, and let me tell you, they make very big messes. I become their number one pooper scooper.
I don't need details right now. Now, what do you gain personally out of this experience? Is it nice?
Well, I plan to work with animals in my career. I want to be a child psychologist and use animals as type of therapy for children. So when children come in, it's an educational program. And when they come in, I get to see how they react, and I can use it one day.
All right, now, you talk to younger kids about dating. What do you tell them?
Well, I tell them all guys are scum. I'm just kidding.
No. Wait a minute. We have some male judges here. Be careful, lady.
I'm just kidding. I said that because my dad doesn't want me to ever date. But I really...
He's like every father, believe me.
Yeah, he is. But really, I tell him that when you want to date, you set standards for dating so you know that if uncomfortable situations can occur, and you can learn how to handle those situations properly.
Very good. Thank you very much. Please step over here for the judges, if you will. This is Miss Georgia. All right, next is Miss South Carolina, Lauren Papel, 18 years of age, recent high school grad. She has a 3.7 grade point average, enjoys dancing and aerobics. Are your mom and dad here?
They sure are.
In the audience?
Oh, yeah, right over there.
All right, we'll probably get a shot of them. And your grandparents were here before you got to Mississippi Beach?
Yes, my grandparents came here before I got here. They had to bring all of my clothes because I had so much, and they're so excited, so they had to get here before me.
Have they been enjoying their stay?
Oh, yeah, and I think everyone in Biloxi knows who they are.
this is kind of a silly question. You mean they've met everybody by now?
Oh, yeah.
is there such a thing as a Mr. South Carolina pageant? They have a male equivalent?
Actually, there isn't, but I wish there was because it's kind of like a joke between me and my friends. We go around and we pretend that we're kind of judging for it and everything.
If you were a judge, what would you look for in those men you were looking over?
He has to be really good looking, he has to have a great personality, and look really good in swimsuit.
Well, I'm not gonna touch that one. Thank you very, very much. If you will, please step over here for the judges. This is Miss South Carolina. All right, here's Miss Indiana, Kelly Lloyd. She's 16 years of age from Indianapolis, an all-conference track star, has worked with the Christmas Seals Youth Ambassador for the Indiana Lung Association. How did you get associated with the Lung Association?
Well, actually, it was through a pageant title, and they recently invited me to attend Camp Super Kids, which is a camp for asthmatic children, to speak to the children about learning about their asthma, learning how to cope with it. And
now what makes you an authority on asthma?
I'm an asthmatic.
All right. Now we got to establish that. You and I know that, but they don't. Now, is this something that, as a young person with asthma, what would you tell parents who have an asthmatic child?
I think it's important for parents to know that their child, although they do have limitations, to still let them be a child. And it's important to let them have fun. And it's important to learn a lot about asthma. A lot of people don't take it seriously, but it is serious. It's a disease.
All right. Let me jump from the serious to the light. What do you do for fun?
I like to go fishing with my dad.
Who's the better fisher person? Notice, fisher person these days, correct?
Actually, neither one of us really catch anything very often.
So you're both lousy fishermen, is that it? Please step over here for the judges. This is Miss Indiana. All right, coming up now is Miss Ohio, Melissa Yust. She's 16 years old. She's a junior from Cincinnati with a 3.5 grade point average. You like to camp and travel. Your family has pets.
A lot of pets. We have a dog and we have a skunk, but she's depewed, so she can't spray anybody.
She is what?
Depewed.
Oh, I see. She can't. Yeah, I got you.
Right.
And how many other things do you have around?
We have a bunny and a snake, and we have 42 ducks in our backyard.
I heard you say that in the swimsuit thing. How did you acquire 42 ducks?
Every summer we would get 4 ducks, and we'd raise them, and in the winter they would fly away, and in the summer they would come back and they'd bring their mates. So we've been doing that for a few years, and now we have a lot of ducks.
That's great. All right, now let me change subject a second. You're going to have an exchange student at your house. Is that person male or female, or don't you know?
Probably female.
Do you know from where?
Germany, somewhere in Germany. I don't know.
Hopefully this person likes animals.
Hopefully, yes.
All right, now you're going to be an exchange student. Where will you go?
I will go to Germany. Hopefully I'll get a chance to go.
Why? I mean, why select Germany?
Well, basically my family is German. Their backgrounds are German, so I took German in high school, and I'd like to go.
Sprechen Sie Deutsch?
Yes.
Jawohl.
Yeah.
Please step over here for the judges, if you will. This is Miss Ohio. All right, next is Miss Oregon. This is Jill Chartier. She's 18 years old, attends the University of Oregon, wants to become a dentist. And I guess I got to ask you the question. Everybody's afraid of dentists. Why did you select dentistry?
Well, in the eighth grade, I became interested in dentistry. I've always loved people's smiles and their teeth, and I just thought if I can help brighten someone's smile, then, hey, it's worth it.
So you're going to be an orthodontist?
Well, I'm thinking about orthodontics because you seem to be a lot more appreciative, you know, towards people that, you know, put braces on, whereas if you get a cavity filled, you're not quite as appreciative.
Aren't you afraid of being in a dentist chair?
No. I fall asleep like a hairdresser. I kind of puts me to sleep.
While the and is going on. Now, you also have a secret desire to be an entertainer, whether you're going to be singer, dancer, talker, what?
Actually, I love acting. I love comedy, a lot of comedy, so.
Somebody told me your favorite show is Saturday Night Live.
Yeah.
You do a little impression of somebody. What was the character's name, Pat? I thought I'd nail you with this. This, if you're familiar with the show, there's a character named Pat. Give me about this much of Pat.
I thought this was a co-ed pageant. Where's Chris and Robin and Terry?
Thank you very much. Would you step over here? That's Miss Oregon. Thank you, ladies. That completes our first 6 interviews.
Okay, I'm backstage with some of the girls who were just interviewed. There's Miss Pat. Come over here, Jill. Okay. Now, that was pretty good. You had them laughing out there.
Yeah, I had myself laughing, too.
Do you think you did a good job up there?
Oh, I don't know. I made them laugh, so I guess that's good enough for me. I don't know.
It worked. And you know what? Now, you said your father doesn't want you to date Dinesha, but come on. Do you have a boyfriend?
No, and if he had his choice, I'd be locked up in my room forever.
give me his phone number. I'll talk to him for you. Okay, the rest of the semifinalists are ready to compete, so stay tuned. We'll continue the interviews right after this word from CoverGirl Cosmetics. CoverGirl, redefining beautiful.
Beautiful is the ultimate look. Naturally.
Introducing Ultimate Finish Liquid Powder Makeup.
A CoverGirl first.
The revolutionary makeup that covers like liquid.
Fluidly, flawlessly.
Then instantly transforms to the soft, natural finish of a powder.
Weightless. Wondrous.
The ultimate makeup for the ultimate natural look.
Beautiful is.
New Ultimate Finish Liquid Powder Makeup. Redefining beautiful.
Most people are experts on something they like. Moi, I'm an expert on grease. Something I hate. So anything that might clean grease, you name it, I tried it. Of course, all that trying stopped when I found Dawn.
Dawn's the best at breaking up grease and taking it away.
Did I say cleaning grease? I meant repelling.
Better at getting grease off. Dawn's also better at keeping grease from getting back on.
Grease experts, hey. Takes one to know one.
Dawn takes grease out of your way.
Try new Double Power Surf.
Hmm.
Other detergents seem watery,
But Surf is packed so thick with double the cleaning power, half the liquid gets out the toughest dirt and odors. See?
Presenting some more of the 2,000 body parts you can clean with Lever 2000, the deodorant soap that's better for your skin and all your 2,000 parts.
Semi-final interview competition continues now, and let's talk with Miss Tennessee, Jamie Dudney. She's 17 years of age, lives in Nashville, wants to direct television and music videos someday. I read a little bit about you, and you said you were adventurous. Is that true? What sort of adventurous things have you done?
Absolutely. I fly airplanes and helicopters.
I mean, in your spare time, anything else? You were whitewater rafting or any of that stuff?
Well, I've been a cheerleader for 6 years, and that's real adventurous because we climb up to the top and fall down and get right back up.
You do those gymnastic type things.
Oh, yeah. 6 years of that, too.
Where do you inherit your adventurous spirit? From whom?
My family. They teach me how to be real adventurous. They go on with me whitewater rafting, snow skiing. I've been snow skiing since I was about that big.
Isn't your dad a helicopter pilot?
Oh, my dad. Yeah, he's a helicopter pilot. He flies Hughes 500 helicopters, and he's my instructor.
All right, now, I want to change subjects completely. You go on a date, and they told me, I don't know this to be true, you take your 7-year-old brother?
I do. My 7-year-old brother is my best friend, and also, if my date doesn't get along with my brother, he's out of there.
I mean, I know he... Is he here in the audience?
Oh, absolutely. He wouldn't miss it for the world.
This guy's got to be a great judge of men. Has he ever turned a date down for you?
Oh, no. He's been very generous to me, and we go camping together. We dress up in camouflage and go out and hunt army men.
This is a unique situation for you to get along with a 7-year-old girl. What's his name?
His name's Nathaniel.
We'll dedicate this to him. Step over here for the judges, if you will, please. This is Miss Tennessee. All right, coming up is Miss Connecticut. She's Cynthia Schneck. She's 17 years of age. She has a 3.6 grade point average. Her hobbies include piano, dancing, doing volunteer work. You're about to become a senior. Have you been checking out schools, colleges, and so forth?
Yes, I'd like to attend Brigham Young University.
What are you going to study?
Pediatric nutrition.
What got you on that sort of track? I mean, you're taking care of little kids and watching their health and all. What inspired you?
Well, I'd always wanted to be a pediatrician, but I thought it'd be kind of hard to balance a family and being on call all the time, so that's why I decided to specialize in nutrition.
You know, I've discovered this year that all of you women are very, very much into the health conscious thing. Why all of a sudden has this happened? Kids used to come here and gorge and eat junk food and all. It doesn't happen anymore.
No, I think we've looked to the past generations and seen how many health problems they have, and we're more aware of it now, and we take care of our body and eat more healthy and exercise.
All right, now this is a little embarrassing. You can get into a lot of trouble in Mississippi. Have you eaten well while you're here?
Definitely.
I put on more pounds in 3 days than I care to mention. What are you going to tell everybody when you get back home to Connecticut about Mississippi Beach?
Tell them that Mississippi is wonderful. The southern hospitality is great.
They kill you with kindness. Thank you so much. Please step over here. This is Miss Connecticut. Next is Miss Hawaii, Juliana Kaulakahui. And I'm going to let you do that name again because I tried all week. She's 18 years old. She has a 3.9 grade point average. She was voted Miss Congeniality. Now say your last name. I've tried, God bless me, I've tried all week. Kaulakahui. No.
Kaulukukui.
How many letters are there in the Hawaiian alphabet?
A lot. About 13.
13? That's about half the normal. That's why I'm in trouble already. Now, all right. You said somewhere along the way that you wanted to do a television show from Hawaii?
Yes, I'd love to do a television show broadcast right from Honolulu, Hawaii, and it'd be like a magazine show focusing on everything unique to Hawaii, from culture to educational things to fashion to anything fun.
Would it be controversial?
Partly.
Would you do interviews?
Yeah.
All right, I'm a guest. I'm asking for trouble. What would you ask me?
What is your favorite animal cracker?
You dirty dog. The hippo. No, I don't know. You're not serious. Would you do that? That Barbara Walters would never ask me that.
No, but I would.
All right, fair enough. Now, there's a big issue in Hawaii these days on the serious side about self-rule sovereignty. What's going on?
Well, the culture is becoming split apart, and they want to have a nation within a nation or complete sovereignty. So it's an issue that's very much on the uproar and very much in the headlines.
How do you feel about it?
I feel that we should stay a part of America because that's our roots, and that's the main thing that brought us to be where we are today.
Thank you very much. Please step over here for the judges. This is Miss Hawaii. All right, next is Miss Vermont, Charlotte Lopez. She's 16 years of age from Dorset. She's a high school senior who's won several writing awards. She's about to write a book called Lost in the System. Now, what's that about?
Well, I'm a foster child of 13 years, and I thought it'd be interesting to write a book about my experiences as a foster child, because whenever people ask me about it, they always seem fascinated. So I said, why not? And it's always easier for me to understand my life when I write it down.
Charlotte, in the 13 years you were with foster families, how many families were there?
At least six.
Mm-hmm. Now, you were given a choice by the state to be adopted or to go out on your own, and you elected adoption. Why?
Well, actually, I had the opportunity to get an apartment for my senior year, and they were going to pay for it, and I was going to have total freedom for my senior year. My friends were all for it. It's like, yeah, you know,
yeah, go for it.
But I thought about it, and I thought about what's going to happen in the long run. I wanted a family that when I go to college, I can come back to when I have kids. I could bring them back and say, this is your grandma and this is your grandfather.
That's a nice thought.
To me, that was more important. Mm-hmm.
What sort of changes should there be in the foster care system?
Well, I think they should be a little bit more organized. I'm lost in the system, and I think there's a lot of kids out there that are. And I feel that there's a little bit more organization, and kids would be placed in homes that would be good for them instead of being switched around to all different homes like I was.
You are very together. Would you please step over here for the judges? Thank you very much. This is Miss Vermont. Next is Miss Maine, Jill Erin Mellon, 16 years of age from Hollis. She's a high school junior, been a dancer for 12 years. Your family just, what does it say, bought a team of Alaskan Huskies?
Yes, my father just in December decided to start raising sled dogs.
Wait a minute, just a second. What does a team consist of? How many?
Well, right now we only have seven because we bought them as a team that another man had already formed, but he's looking into breeding them and buying other dogs to breed them with.
How many will it eventually be? You're not going to give up the car, are you?
No, but some kennels can get to around 200 dogs.
Wow. You like animals?
Yes, I love animals.
Does this play any part in your future? You're going to be a vet or anything like that?
Well, I'd like to be a marine biologist.
What does a marine biologist do? Obviously, there's a lot of animal life under the water. What's the objective?
Well, they study and research dolphins and whales in their natural habitat, dealing with humans, and just to see how they react and whether they like to be in captivity or better to be in their natural habitat.
Interesting work. Now, on the lighter side, you work with Mel Gibson?
Yes.
What were you doing? I mean, it's every woman's desire. What were you doing?
Well, I was in a movie called Man Without a Face, which he directed and also starred in.
Did you say anything?
Well, I screamed. I talked kind of.
You screamed at Mel Gibson?
No, I screamed at his younger co-star.
The millions of people the world over will go to see you do that. Right now, they're looking for you to step over here for the judges, all right? This is Miss Maine. Coming up, Miss Pennsylvania, Ursula Abbott. She's 17 years of age from Harrisburg, going to be a senior this year. Ursula is one of those names that not a lot of people have. Is it a family name?
Well, I have three great aunts that are Ursula nuns.
Ursula nuns?
Yes.
Did they have any influence on you as to selecting being a nun as a career?
Well, I thought about it, but that was about it.
You elected to be an entertainer?
Definitely.
What sort of, do you school yourself for this? You've been training?
Well, I love to sing. I've been singing since I can remember.
Where do you go to school? Where have you been attending school?
Well, I go to Bishop McDevitt in the morning, and then in the afternoon, I go to an arts magnet school where I study music theater.
When you get into that sort of thing, do they audition you?
Yes, we've all had to audition to get in. That's why it's such a great school, because everybody's there because they want to be. They've auditioned, and they worked hard to get there.
What did you do to get in? What sort of an audition?
I sang. I could have danced all night.
Give me one line. Just that you don't have an orchestra, give me a couple of notes.
I could have danced
stone
not. Oh, don't. You're breaking my heart. Thank you very much. Please step over here, if you will. This is Miss Pennsylvania. Thank you very much, ladies. That completes our semifinal interview competition for Miss Teen USA 1993.
Pretty good, Ursula. All right, let's see how the judges place them in the interview competition. Oh boy, Miss Vermont is up top. I'm not surprised. What a touching story she told. And there is Miss Pennsylvania right behind her. Now, you may remember Vermont was third in the swimsuit competition, and now her composite score puts her ahead of everybody. However, the evening is still early, and there's time for everyone to catch up. Now, the last of the semifinal events, the evening gown competition, will be coming up soon. And when we come back, the contestants are going to check out one of the hottest dance hits of the year in a great musical number. Don't miss it.
Now, they may try to improve a pad by making it thinner.
Are you kidding?
They may put wings on it.
So it won't fly.
They may even make it smaller.
Not small enough.
A Tampax tampon is smaller, so it fits naturally inside to protect you sooner.
Naturally.
So while they may keep changing it,
it's still a pad.
And not as comfortable to wear as a Tampax tampon. For great comfort and a dollar savings on Tampax tampons, look in Sunday's paper.
Hair in salon condition. Sassoon knows how that feels.
It's you. Amplified. It's you. In the spotlight.
And we know how hard it is to keep that feeling at home. So we created special conditioners that disappear. Don't wear hair down like others.
We'll give you the hair.
Sassoon Hair. Salon feel at home.
You take it from there, and I'll Sassoon. We'll give you the hair. You take it from there.
The 1993 Miss Teen USA pageant will continue.
We'll be right back!
The secrets of summer are unfolding. But there's one secret nobody knows.
The secret.
What is Macaulay West really doing in Springfield? And who is he really after? There's only one way to find out.
Quick.
Turn on the light.
Guiding light.
An outlaw turned lawman in a small Texas town.
I'm Ned Blessing.
Where bad folks needed a lesson from a leader. Without fear, from the writer-producer of Lonesome Dove, premiering August 18th, Med Blessing.
Faye Dunaway, Robert Urich. It had to be him. It had to be her. It had to be you. Fridays this fall. This is CBS.
Where are you going to find authentic barbecue? With lean, slow-roasted roast beef, marinated and simmered in a rich, tangy barbecue sauce? Look no further than Arby's, where now our barbecue sandwich is only $1.49, which means authentic barbecue just got real easy to find. The barbecue, only $1.49, only at Arby's.
If we could only get into Village Inn.
I'd give my left ear for one of those new salads.
The experts love our salads. And now we've got four brand new ones that'll have you jumping up and down, too.
Oh, are you sure this is gonna work?
Trust me!
Yeah, drop on in, have you been?
Drop on in.
We've got what you're hungry for.
Sorry, guys.
Thanks a lot!
I'm all funny!
You're a hamster!
Don't forget, we've got the pies you're hungry for, too.
You're watching KMTV, Channel 3, your top story station.
Welcome back to Mississippi Beach and our live broadcast. And believe me, with 51 teenagers on this stage, live is the appropriate word. And you'll see why right now as they step into their Nike cross trainers and hot-footed down to CD Heaven for a personal appearance by somebody very special. All right, ladies, keep it coming.
Shake it the way something.
through the bodies here. Jamie, that was terrific. Let me give you a hand up there. Thank you ever so much. Ladies, take a bow. Come on. There you go. Nicely done. Now, the good news is evening gowns are next. The bad news is you're in the wrong outfits. Go! You know, these young women go home with a lot of new friendships and a lot of happy memories, but the lucky teen who wins tonight will also take home more than $150,000 in cash and gifts. Here's our reigning Miss Teen USA, Jamie Solinger, again to help Arthel tell you what awaits our winner.
CoverGirl awards $7,500 and a year's supply of CoverGirl products, including new CoverGirl Ultimate Finish Liquid Powder Makeup. Covers just like a liquid, then instantly transforms to a soft powder finish. New Ultimate Finish Liquid Powder from CoverGirl. From new Arateen Image, Miss Teen USA received $7,500 cash and a year's supply of Arateen Image, clear deodorants and pastel antiperspirants that keep you cool and confident so you can get a little closer. Miss Teen USA receives a year's supply of Ogilvy Precisely Right, the home firm you just can't get wrong. Precisely Right by Ogilvy, the official home firm of the Miss Teen USA pageant, also awards $7,500 to the winner who is precisely right. From Caboodle, she wins $7,500 plus those Hot Caboodles cosmetic organizers. Bright colors, great style, and lots of space make it easy to get organized. Caboodles, put your life into it. From Bonner College in Atlanta, a two-year college scholarship offering Associate of Arts degrees in fashion merchandising, fashion design, or interior design. Plus selected liberal arts courses, of course. From Hawaiian Tropic Sun Care Products, Miss Teen USA receives a one-week vacation in Hawaii for two. Hawaiian Tropic World-Class Sun Protection, available in over 85 countries around the world. Aloha from Hawaiian Tropic. From Catalina Juniors, Miss Teen USA receives $5,000 plus a $3,000 wardrobe of Catalina's exciting swimwear, sportswear, and activewear in fresh designs and colors. Catalina, the official swimwear of the 1993 Miss Teen USA pageant. Miss Teen USA will have the time of her life on board Carnival Cruise Line's Fun Ship Celebration. She'll cruise the Caribbean for 7 days and discover why Carnival is the most popular cruise line in the world. She receives the incomparable Minolta Maxim 7XI SLR system, the world's most intelligent camera, plus a Minolta camcorder, a Minolta fax machine, and the world's first autofocus binoculars, only from the mind of Minolta. The Contact Lens Council awards Miss Teen USA $7,500 plus $500 in vision care for her family. Many of the Miss Teen USA delegates are among the 24 million Americans who enjoy great vision and good looks with contact lenses. See the difference contact makes. She wins a $12,000 shopping spree at world-famous Flemington's, where she'll choose from a huge selection of leather and fur coats styled for all occasions. Awarded by Flemington Fur Company, Flemington, New Jersey. Tonight's winner receives a brand new 1994 Pontiac Sunbird convertible, and it's loaded for fun. Comes with standard anti-lock brakes and delivers 3.1-liter V6 performance. Sunbird convertible from Pontiac. We are driving excitement.
Those prizes are fantastic. I wonder if I'm too old to get in this pageant. All right, anyway, the most beautiful competition, the evening gown competition, is up next. Oh, look at you. You look great.
Thank you, and so do you.
I might not talk to anybody the rest of the show. Okay, you have to give us the inside scoop on this.
You know, some of these girls, they get hysterical over their gowns, but I don't really think it matters. I hated my gown when I ran in my competition, and I won anyway.
See? So it's about stage presence.
Yes, it is. And you know Miss Pennsylvania, Ursula Abbott? She won the preliminary gown competition. And she practiced by walking down the steps of her state capitol at night in her gown and her high heels. And she only fell down once.
It sounds like Rocky, don't you think?
Yeah, doesn't it? Also, check out Miss Vermont, Charlotte Lopez. Her gown was only $37.99, and she just added a few beads and a scarf. And Miss Maine, Jill Erin Mellon, designed her gown with her mother, and her mom made it at home.
I like that. I like that.
Me too.
So it's not how expensive it is, but it's how you wear it. All right, well, stay with us, and you will see a beautiful new look for our contestants.
You work harder, you get better, right? But working to condition my perm made it flatter. Then I found this, a new Pert Plus, just right for perms. Using a separate conditioner after you shampoo can flatten your perm. This is better. It leaves hair fuller. It cleans gently, then conditions just where you need it. So your hair is fuller and soft, too.
New Pert Plus for permed and color-treated hair. Fuller hair. No fuss.
Hey, you know what they're doing in there? It's great. Red Lobster's got this enormous shrimp platter. You get to mix and match 30 shrimp for just $9.99. You get 30 shrimp in whatever combination you choose of grilled shrimp, fried shrimp, or scampi. Mix and match 30 shrimp into the combination you love best for just $9.99. My son even got a kid's shrimp meal for just $2.99. But hurry, it all ends August 22nd at Red Lobster.
Hi, it's me. We're meeting at 10:30. And guess what? Kevin's gonna be there.
Your face is the first thing people see when they meet you. So why use anything but Noxzema? It's better than soap. Better for your face. It dissolves oil without over-drying. Soap doesn't. Noxzema. Every time you wash, every day. You will have your face all your life. Take care of it. For healthy-looking skin.
Your face belongs to Noxzema.
I brush my teeth 3 times a day, so just imagine when the dentist said, Annie, you've got tartar. And he reached for that pick. Doctor, I asked, isn't there an easier way? He said, Annie, use the tougher toothpaste, Tartar Control Crest.
Because of Crest's exclusive tartar-fighting formula, we're so sure you'll have less tartar in 6 months, we'll give you a money-back guarantee.
So I started using Tartar Control Crest, and my next visit's great.
Less tartar in 6 months guaranteed from Crest, the dentist's choice.
Now I don't get picked on so much anymore.
Well, my older sister I drove absolutely nuts. And I guess the piece of advice that was born of those days that still holds true today is when you go into the bathroom, close the door. You know, that still stays with me. I hear her words, you know. And then my younger sister, who is one of the smartest people that I've ever been around, she won't give me her phone number. So I don't know what to say there.
It's kind of sad.
It is a little sad, sure.
Welcome back to our live show. You know, there are literally hundreds of people here in the Mississippi Beach area who have given us of their time and effort to make our visit possible. And we'd like to thank all of them by introducing the chairperson of the Mississippi Beach Pageant Host Committee, Mrs. Jeannie Beattie. Jeannie, would you take a bow? And the Lieutenant Governor of the great state of Mississippi, the Honorable Eddie Briggs. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. It's time now for tonight's most beautiful event as our contestants set a dreamy mood for the evening gown competition. Competition, our semi-finalists will wear gowns of their own choice, and they'll be serenaded by the Mississippi Gulf Coast Teen Orchestra and chorus. It's our tradition to ask local boys to participate in Miss Teen USA, sort of a reminder of the little brothers back home. And now here are the 12 semifinalists with their special escorts, some handsome young gentlemen from Mississippi Beach in the 1993 Evening Gown Competition. And we begin with Miss New York.
Thank you. Georgia. South Carolina.
Miss Maine.
Concludes our evening gown competition and our semifinals. Thank you, ladies and young gentlemen.
Absolutely gorgeous. And those little boys are so adorable, too, don't you think? All right, now we're going to see how the judges score this last event and the semifinals. Oh boy, topping that category, not surprised, Miss Pennsylvania. But look, Miss Vermont is not far behind. And to think that she only paid $37.99 for the dress. And there is Miss New York right behind them. Miss Hawaii, not too far behind either. I'm not surprised that she's pretty high up there. All right, remember, these scores are now being added to the scores for the swimsuit competition and the interview competition. And the six highest composite scores will determine the finalists. We will find out who they are when we come back.
Wouldn't you give anything to hair this shiny and healthy? Blow drying gave me split ends. But Pantene Pro-V shampoo and treatment conditioner helped change all that. Pro-V contains provitamins which go deep into your hair, giving it extra treatment all the way to the tips. And look, it's so healthy, it shines.
Pantene Pro-V shampoo and treatment conditioner. For hair so healthy, it shines.
It won't happen overnight, but it will happen.
Because you never see it coming. Then it comes at the worst time. Diarrhea takes you out of control. Introducing Pepto-Diarrhea Control Caplets, a whole different medicine from Pepto-Bismol. So powerful it often stops diarrhea in just one dose. No other caplet stops diarrhea better. Take control in one dose with new Pepto-Diarrhea Control Caplets.
Hey, Mom, what's that white thing?
See? New Whitewater Zest.
Uh-oh, it's gonna get me. Mmm, smells good.
Zest Fully Clean.
There, doesn't that feel smooth?
Soap leaves a film you can feel on your skin. But New Whitewater Zest rinses cleaner than soap, so your family's skin feels smoother than soap.
Yes, smooth.
Zest Fully Clean.
You're the guy who took my zest.
Poor Daddy.
New Whitewater Zest.
You're not fully clean unless you're Zest Fully Clean.
Hey, have you heard about new raspberry ice? It's the newest flavor from Crystal Light. Go ahead, taste it. That's new raspberry ice Crystal Light. The newest way to turn water into wow.
It's coming over the hill, Sarge.
Hit the line, boys.
Bigfoot.
2 square feet of pizza and a tasty new crust, all for $10.99. Bigfoot Pizza, the biggest pizza you can get delivered.
Okay, we are back live, and we will soon learn who the six finalists are. Now, while those scores are being verified, why don't we take a closer look at this great Mississippi Beach area with our reigning Miss Teen USA. Take it away, Jamie.
To the beautiful Mississippi Beach. From there atop the Biloxi Lighthouse, you can see miles of coastline stretching along the warm waters of the Gulf of Mexico. Hey, do you want to have fun? You can do it here. Or you can just also lay on back and soak up some rays.
The Gulf is full of all kinds of fish, just waiting to be caught. And some of them will even challenge the best fishermen and women.
Hey, where'd you come, Casey?
Something drier? Like
like chasing the little white ball around some of the area's beautiful golf courses.
Great shot!
Love the knickers.
There's enough sun in Mississippi to work up an appetite. Mississippi is home to dozens of great restaurants. This is my favorite dish. You've got to try the crab spiders.
These warm Gulf waters are very important to Mississippi's economy. It's boats like these that bring in 300 tons of shrimp a year.
And ships carry an assortment of cargo from around the world, come and go from busy Gulfport Harbor. After you're done here, where are you going to be going?
Be going back to Costa Rica.
How long of a trip?
2.5 days.
Oh, wow.
Welcome to you. Welcome aboard the USS Bellagard.
Thank you. And speaking of ships, when the military wants state-of-the-art vessels, they order them from Ingalls Shipbuilding.
And this is our actual bridge area. This is actually where we drive the ship from.
From Mississippi Beach, this ship will be launched to patrol the world's oceans. The Magnolia State is proud of its southern heritage and its role in history. From the Civil War to the days of pirate ships along the Gulf Coast. Rumor has it that if you visit Ship Island, you might even see the ghost of one buccaneer who's still looking for his buried treasure. Mississippi has a great musical heritage. My favorite is the blues, the music that has a story to tell.
On Mississippi Beach, the newest entertainment is gaming, with the dazzling dockside casinos all along the coast.
And with antique stores like this one and the charming little town of Bay St. Louis, you can even take some of the past home with you.
Looking for overnight accommodations? There's lots of great hotels and resorts on Mississippi Beach. And as you've seen, there's fun and excitement for everyone on the beautiful coast. And the Southern hospitality will make you feel right at home on Mississippi Beach.
Thank you, Jamie, very much. As soon as we come back here, we've got our 12 semifinalists. Can I have that printout, Bill? This is the thing we've all been waiting for here. All right. I have the names of the six contestants who scored the highest in the semifinals and who will now continue in the finals. And once again, ladies, I'll call these out in random order. Good luck to all. Here are the final six. Miss Georgia. Miss Indiana.
There's your girl.
Miss New York. Three to go. Miss Pennsylvania. Miss Hawaii. That's five. One more. Miss Vermont. Ladies and gentlemen, the six finalists for the title of Miss Teen USA 1993.
I'm so excited for those girls. We know they're so happy to be the finalists. Want to know if your favorites made it. We also know, though, they're thinking about what's coming up next, the judges' questions.
Right, because this round of competition will narrow the field to just three contestants.
Again, all previous scores are erased, and they begin competing on equal footing.
You'll still see the judges' individual scores, but no composite score. That creates a bit more suspense about who's going to make the final three.
Now, the judges' questions are unpredictable, so why don't you stay tuned and see what happens after this word from Max Factor International. Find out what happens after the factor.
She discovered that Max Factor's new eyeshadow gave her high-definition eyes. But then what?
A cute guy had been making eye contact from behind the pages of a Dickens classic. When she passed by him, she smiled and said, "Great book. It's even better right side up."
Impact.
Max Factor's new high-definition eyeshadow. Rich, refined, eyes they'll read up on. Max Factor International.
Name the toughest thing to clean in your bathroom.
That slippery slime on my tub. That grimy gunk on my shower walls.
On my shower door, that stuff.
Introducing Comet Bath Spray. The new bath spray that cleans the toughest kinds of grime. Comet Bath Spray thoroughly cleans tough soap scum and hard water stains. Even in bathtubs and on shower walls.
It even cleaned that nasty drip mark thing.
New Comet Bath Spray. Comet sprays the tough stuff away.
This Team USA pageant will continue.
Y'all come back.
Next Tuesday at a special time. Jack Nicholson. Michael Keaton. Batman.
Bert knows people.
She's the town bullhorn.
Bert knows television.
VCR is a beta.
I made a choice. I'm sticking with it.
Bert knows his friends.
There's one thing the people will always need, and that's talk.
I think it's the stuff that would come out if we were to squeeze your head.
Get to know Bert and the boys Friday, August 20th.
After 17 years, Ray Don Snow is coming home. Home to a town that forgives, but never forgets. Chelsea Field, James Brolin, Peggy Lipton, and Gene Simmons starred this season's most romantic new series. So keep your eyes on this road. Next stop, Angel Falls. Premieres August 26th.
This is CBS.
Tonight at 10 on Channel 3, your top story station.
Hello, everyone. I'm Trina Creighton. A kink in the law is causing a bias in cocaine-related sentencing tonight, and it matters in Mid-America. I'll show you why African-American men are four times more likely to be arrested and convicted in these drug crimes than white men, and what's being done to change the system. Also ahead, we'll show you what's going on with those 2,000 kids stopping in Omaha on their journey to meet the Pope. John Mason will be live tonight at Burke High School. That's tonight on Eastern 3 at 10.
We asked Al Rocky Rodriguez, demolition engineer and longtime Mountain Dew drinker, to sample new Kick Soda. He liked the taste with a kick.
Sunflowers by Van Gogh, 79 million. Blue Boy by Gainsborough, 42 million. Casey Masterpiece Pizza by Pizza Hut, $9.99. Introducing Barbecue Chicken Pizza, made with tender white chicken breast, and Barbecue Meat Lovers Pizza, both made with Casey Masterpiece barbecue sauce. Get a medium Casey Masterpiece pizza for just $9.99.
Now this is a masterpiece.
You're watching KMTV, Channel 3, your top story station.
Welcome back to our live broadcast from Mississippi Beach. This is the round of competition which will determine the final three contestants, the judges' questions. Now, each young lady will draw a judge's name from this bowl and respond to a question that judge has asked. The contestant will have 20 seconds in which to answer, and while voting, the judges will consider the answer. They'll also see a video reminder of each contestant competing earlier in the semifinals so they can base their votes on their overall impression of her this whole evening. The score from that judge asking the question will be highlighted on your screen. And we'll begin with Miss Georgia. You come over and select the first question. All righty, let's see. This comes from judge number 4, Ernie Reyes, Jr. Ernie, may we have your question, please?
Can. A recent Harris poll revealed that nearly 40% of students knew somebody who had been injured or killed by a gun. What do you think can be done about this problem?
I think the problem starts within the home, and I think we need to start telling our children what the dangers of possessing a gun are and how to prevent from doing that. First of all, we should tell them that the guns are dangerous and that you shouldn't point them at anyone and that you shouldn't play with one because it could be loaded. And I think that we should stay within the school and tell other kids there too.
Thank you very much. Please hold here for just a moment.
Georgia has never won this pageant, but Dinesha has a lot of support from home.
Not only your parents and her other family are here, but even her first grade teacher.
right, if you rejoin the other ladies, Miss Indiana, will you come forward, please, and select a question from the bowl? Anyone? All right, let's see. We have a question from judge number one, Kathleen Noon. Kathleen, your question is?
Yes. Women have recently been appointed to many high-level government posts. If you could choose a government position for your future, what job would you choose and why?
I believe that I would like to be the governor of Indiana. I think there are a lot of wonderful things going on in Indiana, and I know that my hometown, Indianapolis, is growing by the minute, and I would definitely like to take charge and possibly improve our educational program in Indiana and get a few campaigns started.
Thank you very much. Will you hold here for just a moment?
Her mom's goal for Kelly was to make the top 12, and here she is in the finals.
And back home in Indiana, 50 of her preschool dance students are cheering her on.
All right, thank you very much, Miss New York. If you'll come up and join us now, just put these questions in here. You can grab one of them. Turn that one that way. All right, this is from judge number nine, Noreen Donovan. Noreen, may we have your question, please?
If you could star in any current TV series, which one would you choose and why?
Oh, I think I'd want to star in America's Most Wanted because it's really exciting, and I wouldn't want to be in America's Most Wanted, but I want to be talking about it, and I think the people are really interesting that are on it, but that's what I want to be on.
Not as one of the participants.
No, definitely not one of the participants.
I'll clarify that a little bit. All right, hold on for the judges, please.
Now, Sarah Ray said she chose her evening gown because it reminded her of Cinderella.
I don't know about a handsome prince, but she could win a crown tonight.
Thank you very much. If you'll step back, Miss Pennsylvania. And lots of questions still left in the bowl. Grab one. All right, this is judge number two, Larry Thompson. Larry, may we have your question, please?
Sure. If you could change one thing that has happened to you in your life, what would you change?
Well, I don't think I'd change anything. I've made some mistakes and I have some regrets, but everything that I've done has created the person that I am and different characteristics, and I wouldn't change anything.
Fair enough. Please wait here for just a second.
Ursula was accepted into her state pageant and didn't even know her father sent in a photo.
And he may have changed her life. We'll soon know.
All right, if you'll go back and join the others. Miss Hawaii, if you'll come forward, please, and select a question from the bowl. All right, here we go. This is from judge number five, Ann Gorison. Ann, may we have your question, please?
Sure. What is the most important thing you did to prepare for the pageant?
The most important thing I did to prepare for this pageant was pray daily to God and just thank Him for all the blessings and for this opportunity to be here and just share with all the millions of people across America and all the youth here and all the girls. It's a wonderful opportunity, and I thank God for such a wonderful blessing.
Thank you very much. Please stay here a second.
Juliana says she prepared for the judges' questions by having her sister Tamara grill her.
We'll see if it paid off in a few moments.
Thank you very much. And finally, Miss Vermont, if you'll come over and select a question from the bowl. Let's see who we have this time. This is judge number six, Corey Hirsch. Corey, may we have your question, please?
If Chelsea Clinton invited you to the White House for a visit, what's the one thing you would want to do while you're there?
Well, I'd want to see how she spends her time. Being the daughter of a president must be something that could be hard and also fun. I'd like to spend a day with her, maybe go to school with her for the day, see how she handles being such a role model, because the president is her father, and I think that she is definitely a role model for teenagers today, so I think it'd be interesting to see how she goes about being the president's daughter.
Thank you very much. Hold here for just a moment.
Now, the family that's about to adopt Charlotte couldn't be here tonight, but we know they are watching home, and they're very proud.
And one of her former foster mothers is here in the audience.
If you rejoin the other ladies, please. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes the judges' questions for our six finalists.
Oh, boy, they can really, really think on their feet. All right, Miss Kelly, you're the expert here. Going to put her on the spot. Who's going to make it to the final three?
Well, you know, Vermont has caught the hearts of the audience. It is obvious that she is going to be right up there. Miss Pennsylvania is looking great. She is really hanging in there. She's got strong answers. And, you know, I got to stick with Miss Hawaii. She's my hometown girl.
I know, I know.
Yeah.
All right, well, is she right? And who did you choose? We'll reveal the final three right after this.
See this? This is no room for error. Around this space is the place for a beautiful Ogilvy Precisely Right Perm. Precisely Right automatically times your perm, automatically conditions your hair, and when it's through, it shuts itself off. Which is why no other kind of perm gives you more beautiful, silky, shiny, glorious waves and curls every time. See this? This is no room for error. This is Precisely Right by Ogilvy. You just can't get it wrong.
For powerful bleach-boosted cleaning with the Color Guard of Cheer, try Cheer with Color Guard Bleach.
The image is cool. The image is confident.
You Aritane image!
Clear deodorants, pastel antiperspirants. Fresh, cool scent. Hey, it lets you get a little closer.
You Aritane image!
Now all the cool fruity taste of watermelon is in new Jell-O Watermelon Gelatin.
Make watermelon wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle.
We're delicious.
Wiggle, wiggle.
Now you can have your fun and eat it just.
You better sit down for this. The tampon you probably used was designed a half a century ago by a man. To absorb, it grows longer and longer. A woman, a gynecologist, designed OB. It expands all around, fits all around. It helps prevent fluid from going by. OB, you can stand up for it. And with OB, there's no applicator. It protects you and the environment. OB, you can stand up for it.
And now we come to the next turning point of the evening. May I have this very important little piece of paper? This is a list, the names of the final three contestants chosen by our judges. Once again, ladies, I will name them in random order. The final three are Miss Vermont Charlotte Lopez. Miss Indiana Kelly Lloyd. And Miss Pennsylvania Ursula Abbott. Ladies and gentlemen, one of these three will be the new Miss Teen USA.
Not too bad, Miss Kelly. Two out of three is not bad.
No, not bad. Hawaii didn't make it, but I know everybody's proud of her anyway.
Absolutely. Okay, and I don't want to brag, but those are my three choices.
Oh, yeah. Sure, easy to say now.
No, I'm serious. Really, really. Well, the real tension comes now because they have to face the final question.
This is an important moment. The judges will consider everything the contestant has done this evening, but this question can tip the scales one way or the other.
We're going to see what happens. Now, you will not see any scores in this round, so you're on your own trying to choose the winner. Let's go to it.
Ladies, this is your last round of competition, and this is the final question. You'll all get the same question. You will each have 20 seconds in which to answer. To make it fair, I'll ask Miss Indiana, Miss Pennsylvania, hike it back there to the isolation booth, and we'll play some rushing air so you won't be able to hear what we're doing out here. Everyone gets the same question. We'll wait a second while they get in there. I don't hear any air, gentlemen. Is that true? There it is. Oh, that is such a lovely sound. All right. What do you think makes you an appropriate role model for teenagers in the USA?
Well, being a foster child for 13 years, I've been through so many experiences. I've lived with over 6 foster families. I've learned to live all different ways of life. And I've also lived with over 50 teenagers. So I've also been able to see all different benefits, the disadvantages and advantages of being a teenager. So I feel, through my experiences living in all different foster homes and living with so many different teenagers, I feel that that makes me the best role model.
Thank you very much. If you would, please step over here. Okay. Miss Indiana, please. If you'll come and join me, please, Miss Indiana, we'll ask you the very same question again. And it is, what do you think makes you an appropriate role model for teenagers in the USA?
I think that the important thing that I would definitely speak out to my peers would be the importance of staying in school, setting goals for yourself, completing your education, and trying your best to achieve those goals.
Thank you very much. If you'd step over here for a second. All right, and finally, let's have Miss Pennsylvania release that poor woman from that booth. You can't hear it, but it's up in your ear all the time. Same question, my dear. This is, what do you think makes you an appropriate role model for teenagers in the USA?
I'm ready for the job. I want to get out there and help people and be a role model for the girls. I think I have all the qualities it takes, and I'm ready to do it.
All right, fair enough. If you would please step over here. Nicely done, ladies. Good job. It's time now for the judge's final vote. As each contestant steps forward, the judges will consider her overall impression, the thing that they have over throughout the evening in the competition. They will give each young lady a ranking, 3, 2, or 1, as they vote for her to be the second runner-up, the first runner-up, or the new Miss Teen USA. And we'll begin with Miss Vermont. Next is Miss Indiana. And Miss Pennsylvania. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes our competition for Miss Teen USA 1993.
Oh my, one of those three ladies is about to have her life changed. We will find out who the new Miss Teen USA is in just a moment. Stay tuned.
When the Hart family moved to a small town, they never counted on neighbors like this.
Welcome to the show now, folks.
He's got this thing about Canadians.
They're taking over.
Bo Bridges.
The man who straddles the fence.
And Lloyd Bridges.
It's a sore crotch.
In a new series about finding your heart's desire, Hearts of the West this fall.
She knew Max Factor's high-definition lipstick gave her lips bold, brave color. But then what?
From across the restaurant, the stranger watched her eat, laugh, and smile. When her companion finally left the table, she carefully mouthed the words, "He's my brother."
Max Factor's new high-definition lipstick. Bold, brave, true. Lips they'll listen to. Max Factor International.
Now there's a Liquid Lever 2000 for your germiest parts. Pokey parts and parts that explore. Playful parts and parts that do chores. Parts that you suck on or stick in your ear. Parts that hold on to the parts you hold dear. New Liquid Lever 2000. It not only kills germs, it helps keep germs from coming back. So it's as good for parts that go roaming as it is for parts that stay home. New Liquid Lever 2000, the antibacterial liquid that's better for your skin and all your 2000 parts.
First, it's soccer, then piano lessons, the dry cleaning, get Tom at work.
What's for dinner, Mom?
Sometimes the extra value of McDonald's...
I'm late for ballet!
...is the extra time it gives you.
The image is cool.
The image is confidential.
You irritate an itch!
Clear deodorants, pastel antiperspirants. Fresh, cool scents. Hey, it lets you get a little closer.
You irritate an itch!
Now, they may try to improve a pad by making it thinner.
Are you kidding?
They may put wings on it.
So it won't fly.
They may even make it smaller.
Not small enough.
A Tampax tampon is smaller, so it fits naturally inside to protect you sooner.
Naturally.
So while they may keep changing it,
it's still a pad.
And not as comfortable to wear as a Tampax tampon. For great comfort and a dollar savings on Tampax tampons, look in Sunday's paper.
And now, from beautiful Mississippi Beach, it's time to crown the new Miss Teen USA. And that, of course, means we have to say farewell to the young woman from Iowa who's worn the crown for the past year. Ladies and gentlemen, for the last time as Miss Teen USA, here is Jamie Solinger.
Lorena's Miss Teen USA has been a busy learning experience, combined with finishing my senior year of high school. Since the night I was crowned, I've traveled across the USA and Mexico City. I had the fun of appearing on Santa Barbara and participated in many charity events. I've been most involved in my home state of Iowa with the Farm Aid concert, the Indian Variety Club telethon, and recently in the Flood Bank event. I've made many new friends, and the people at Miss Universe have made a home away from home for me. My love and thanks to my family for their nonstop support, and thank you to all Iowans, especially my state directors and my friends. It's been a wonderful year.
Jamie, thank you very much. Continued much good luck and success. Ladies, you've all been great representatives of your states. You are all winners. You know that. I told you when we were in the commercial, doesn't matter what happens now, you've won already. But good luck to all of you. We're about to reveal the second and first runners-up and the new Miss Teen USA. The accounting firm of Ernst & Young has reviewed the results for accuracy. Mr. Mark Ward will give me the printout. Thank you, Mark. To assist us, please welcome the reigning Miss USA, Michigan's Kenya Moore. And the reigning Miss Universe, Puerto Rico's Dayanara Torres. All right, ladies, take a deep breath. Here we go. The second runner-up is Miss Pennsylvania. Ladies, if you step forward now, please, down here. I'm about to reveal the name of the first runner-up and the new Miss Teen USA. In the event that Miss Teen USA is unable to complete her reign, our first runner-up will become Miss Teen USA. Ladies, if you are ready. The first runner-up is Miss Indiana. Miss Teen USA is Miss Vermont, Charlotte Lopez. Charlotte, congratulations. You are the new Miss Teen USA 1993. The cash awards and gifts worth more than $150,000 are yours. And now, as our entire cast serenade you, please take the stage for the traditional walk as Miss Teen USA will get that crown affixed. Kenya, is it all right? This way, my dear. Congratulations. Thank you. throne now. Charlotte, in your wildest imagination, did you ever think it would happen? Congratulations and thank you so much for a great job. On behalf of Arthel, Neville, Kelly Hu, Dianara, and Kenya, congratulations to you. We'll see you next time for now, Dick Clark. Good night.
This program has been pre-recorded. Thursday.